Welcome back. In this video, let's look at the last exercise related to the for loop. Print a number triangle 5. It needs to print 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's start with a simple thing. Let's try and print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 first, and then we would look at how to print the rest of this stuff. So let's start with creating this method. I'll comment these lines off. And now I can say def print a number triangle and take a number as an input, and I would want to print from 0 to that 1 to that specific number. How can I do that? I in range of 1 to number plus 1 print I. What would happen? Let's check what would happen. Oops, I missed a colon. Let's fix that, and over here I can now call print a number triangle 5. Aha, it's printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on individual lines. I'd want them to delimited by space. How can I do that? I can say end is equal to space. Let's see what would happen now. You can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are all printed on the same line. So what we are doing is, by default, print would print a new line character at the end of each print statement. What we are saying is we don't want a new line character, but we would use space as a delimiter. You can either use double quotes or you can say it in a single quote. So in single quote, I'm putting a space and the output would remain unchanged. So now what we would want to do is we would want to do the same thing. However, we don't want to really print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 all the time. So if I actually put a for loop on top of it, so for loop here, and I would say for, let's say this is for j in range number plus 1 to for I in range 1 to number plus 1 and print. Make sure that you have the alignment right. So this is what is called a loop in a loop. What would happen if I do this? This loop is executed 5 times. So we are doing a loop in a loop, and if I do this, what would happen? You'd see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the whole thing is being printed 5 times. What we want to do is, at the end of each loop execution, we would want to print a new line. So I'll say print, so that we have a new line here, we have a new line here, we have a new line here, and a new line here. Now, you can see that we are printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are printing actually a square. So if you'd see that we pass in a 6, we would see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Because we are saying for I is 1 to 6, we are saying for j is 1 to 6, for I is 1 to 6, print I. That's what we are doing until now, and that's why it's printing a kind of a square. What we want to do is, in the first line, only print up to 1. In the second line, only print up to 2. In the third line, only print up to 1, 2, 3. Fourth line, 1, 2, 3, 4. How can we do that? Think about it. When I'm inside this loop, I can see the j variable, right? So I can say, instead of number plus 1, I would say j plus 1. So for when j has a value of 1, we'll print from 1 to 1. When j has a value of 2, I'll print from 1 to 2. So I'll only print 1 to 4. When j has a value of 3, I'll print from 1 to 3. So let's try and run this and see what would happen. You can see that our number triangle is ready. So what is happening here is we are having a value j which is running from 1 to 6. And the I value only runs from 1 to the specific value of j. So when j is 1, I is 1. When j is 2, I will have a value of 1 and then it will have a value of 2. From when j is 3, I will have a value of 1, 2, and 3. And that's how we are printing the whole thing out. One of the interesting things for you to do would be to try and debug this and try and make sure that you understand everything happening in the background with this method. I hope all the exercises with the for loop have been interesting. One of the important things to note is a couple of these things can be done in a much simpler way with an enhanced version of a for loop using something called a functional programming. But as a beginner, I think this is the best way for you to approach things and for you to understand them. I'll see you in the next step where we would look at other loops present in Python. Until then, bye-bye.